Jehovah is. While we get to Badani, we have to travel through order, Adodo, etc. It therefore became necessary for us to leave this area and follow the determination of Governor Johnson to achieve this within the shortest possible time. Hence, through his untiring efforts and the cooperation of Lagos taxpayers, the Lagos to Ekpero via Ekoekwe and the Lagos to Badagry Road were expeditiously constructed. The Mobadani Johnson era also saw the planning of the ambitious government scheme, which led to the construction of the Lagos Island Inner Ring Road, which was the prelude to the third mainland bridge. The period also saw the planning and execution of the Holiday Inn project and the commencement of the construction of Victoria Island Road. Then, following the change of government at the center and the establishment of the General Mohammed administration, a new governor, the late Shamsuddin Adekunle Lawal, who was then a Navy commander, was posted to the state. The period marked the shift of the capital of the state from Lagos, which had hitherto served the dual purpose of being the federal and state capital, to Ikeja, which has been designated by the late General Marshall as the new capital of Lagos. Unfortunately, the period of 1975-77 was marked by a depletion of the manpower resources of the young state, because it was the period when we lost a number of officers to the general public, which saw the end of a number of family secretaries and other senior and junior officers for various offenses, ranging from divided loyalty, failing health, to diminished productivity. The demoralization which resulted from this mass exodus caused a lull in the activities of government, and more and almost brought government business to a standstill throughout the state. The morale of officers, however, sought to restore with the arrival of the first non-indigenous governor of the state, Godwin Lubisi Kaya, who worked assiduously to restore the spirit of the service. He was a complete gentleman and a very polite and considerate public officer. Although his period almost saw a most upsetting decline in health values, following the introduction of measures aimed at controlling and improving private medical practices in the state, and the consequent negative reaction of the medical doctor, and particularly the doctors, who embarked on strike action, he took the opportunity to recruit a number of expatriate doctors who came in such large numbers that it became possible for the first time to put doctors to the divisional headquarters and the rural areas of the state. It was also during the Pisicano's tenure that the government house was moved to Ikeja. Governor Pisicano was followed by another non-indigenous commander, later Navy Captain Emiti Ugiwe, a no-nonsense, hard-working and straightforward officer. In what demonstrated during the transition period 1978-1979, he took his assignment seriously and was responsible for handing over to the first civilian governor of the state, Governor Latif Karadis Jaffani. Governor Jaffani was a populist administrator who was also an astute politician. His innovative and welfareist programs adhered him to the generality of the people of the state. He introduced the free education scheme at all levels. He was able to abolish the iniquitous chip system which has lowered the standard of education in primary and secondary schools in the state. We also introduced an unprecedented housing scheme, which attempted to solve one of the major problems of the people of the state through the establishment of housing estates for low-income workers and who were the average son, money, allowance, relaxant, etc. He was able to establish a new university, that is the Lagos State University. He also embarked on a massive program of roads and rail construction. His plan to improve on the mass transit provision in the state was aborted with the cancellation of the Metroline scheme, which was designed to move a large number of promoters between Agege and Lagos Island. The period also saw the birth of the state's television station, LTV Channel 5, which was later withdrawn and replaced by LTV Channel 8. At the time, the Lagos TV introduced Lagos Weekend Television, which enabled viewers to get the station non-stop from Friday evening to Monday morning. Therefore, the administration was followed by the Bola Olusegun's administration. This administration was noted for its introduction of the improved set of school buildings, which replaced the functional ones built during the Jakande administration. The governor also involved the citizens in financing of the new school construction program. And in this way, he was able to encourage the participation of Lagos State citizens in the provision of the needs of the state. Omai Akipe introduced the model school, which has been training young students, particularly in the rural areas. Governor Rade Rasaki has attempted to inculcate some discipline, particularly in environmental planning, to the confused and almost lawless atmosphere of the state. A courageous and daring soldier, he has left his mark in the state as an action god. We have high hopes in the new government of our elderly and gentlemanly governor, Sir Michael Odegola, who has been fortunate to have all these loyal, hard-working, dedicated, and largely successful businesses. It is to be hoped that in this time, Lagos State will continue to excel. May I leave you with some observations which are made as a result of recent developments. Lagos State has been established through the joint efforts, cooperation and encouragement of Nigerians and even nationals of other countries. At least 70% of its citizens are non-Lagosians and have made Lagos their home. Lagos State has drawn its citizens from Togo, Ghana, Brazil, Sierra Leone, Ilorin, Abeokuta, Ibadan, Onitsha, etc. We have always lived happily together without any rancor. We have always had our Boko Abuja, Boko Imaru, Agueba, Ijeru, Obalende, Songo, etc. This is the spirit that has built up Lagos and made it the melting pot of all commercial and social life of the country. Let us not sacrifice this vanguard position on the altar of parochial and narrow indigenous and xenophobic ethnic constitution. I thank the organizers of this exercise for giving us the opportunity of having some glimpses into the past. It is, however, said that we should allow our history of the past to influence our present, so that our present may enrich our future without being unduly self-righteous. It is my view that progress of the debate of the past is in real danger of being disputed. Therefore, and urgently, for the establishment of some form of machinery which will bring back the fervor, the patriotic fervor, which has motivated past endeavors of the state operatives, and which has made it possible for the mustard seed that was Lagos State to develop into a mighty tree, which has made it possible for the state to multiply its original one line worth of 10,000 pounds into the billions that are now generated, which has made it possible for us to successfully establish an identity even while sharing the same seat with the federal government without becoming a spoiled child or a freakish state, which has created a commitment and sense of pride in the generations of citizens of the state. The state can be greater still, not by resting on its oars or by groaning in the achievements of the past, but by dedicating ourselves to the service of our state, by distancing ourselves from petty jealousy and rumor peddling, and through determined efforts to harness our hard earned resources and help at employing them only in fruitful directions. Specifically, we should examine the urge to condemn the bad operatives merely in order to establish ourselves. We should selflessly utilize the resources left for us by past operatives by avoiding subjective considerations in the application of such resources to the detriment of the public we serve. We should constructively utilize the reservoir of available sources of our past performance through constant references and consultation with past operatives, as we are now doing in the present exercise, but on a more formal basis. We should finally make deliberate and consistent efforts to maintain the infrastructure provided by government through regular maintenance, in order that we avoid a situation where neglect takes us back to the original situation once again. It would be a pity if the esprit de corps, which has been built up in the excellent civil service of Lagos State, which I am proud to say has been second to none in the country, is allowed to fail. I wonder, therefore, whether the recent innovations, such as the abolition of the post of head of civil service and the introduction of mass exit of young and talented officers with governments which appointed them, have not resulted in throwing away the baby with the bathwater, as the practice negates the known factor of continuity and perpetuity of government. It is accordingly suggested that the federal and state governments should do a rethinking on the matter, not necessarily with a view to returning to the status quo ante, but at least with a view to ensuring stability and the boosting of the morale of the hard-working civil servants whose lives have become very uncertain since the reform. May Lagos State continue to excel.